trauma is the gateway drug. It is the drug that came before substance use. The average age of first drug use for the clients of Dove House is 13 years old. I can guarantee you that something happened to that young girl to make her use drugs or alcohol. Nearly 95% of all of our clients at Dove House have experienced trauma in the form of sexual, emotional, and physical abuse. 90% of the Dove House clients have experienced childhood sexual abuse. So at the core of everything that we do here at Dove House, it's trauma-informed. We understand the client's need to feel safe, empowered, client-driven, and goal-oriented. We know that a woman that began using drugs and alcohol are usually introduced to this at a very young age and by a perpetrator. Hi, I'm Wendy Noe, Executive Director of Dove Recovery House for Women. A few years ago, I walked the doors of Dove Recovery House. It was my first time as an executive director, and quite honestly, I was really excited, but I was really nervous. I have always worked in women's health, and I've been very passionate about serving other women. And while I felt like I was knowledgeable about the issues women face, I was not knowledgeable about substance use disorder. I had had family members that had had addiction, and I was estranged from them. I, like many, I turned away from it. I ignored it. I didn't understand it. I didn't try to understand it. I blamed that person, and I chose not to have any participation in their life. I wasn't knowledgeable on warning signs and decided that it was a choice that they were making. I couldn't be a part of that choice. And yet, coming to Dove House changed my image. This was different. My vision, this image that I had of addiction, of substance use disorder, and those suffering from the disease, completely changed. I saw them as women. I saw them as women who, when they walk through the doors of Dove House, they're vulnerable. They're scared. They're broken. They're defeated. They're sick. But when they walk through the doors of Dove House, they do it with their hands extended out. They need help. They're ready for help. They are ready for the chance to become the absolute best versions of themselves. Their lives have become unmanageable, and they need the help of Dove House to put the pieces of their lives back together. Dove Recovery House for Women is the largest women's recovery residence in Indianapolis. Every night, we serve a total of 40 women. It's the largest transitional housing and recovery program for women in Marion County, and we are certified as a level 4 recovery residence through the Indiana Alliance of Recovery Residences. We are also certified through the Department of Mental Health and Addiction as an outpatient treatment provider. In 2019, Dove House served a total of 85 women with a success rate of 73%. I'm really proud of that statistic because the average percentage for a person that just leaves rehab is less than 40%. Our success rate shows that our model works. It's incredible. It makes sense. It puts the woman at the core of her treatment plan. We look at her as her entire person, not just her substance use. In 2019, 73% of all of our Dove House clients found and maintained employment or were enrolled in school. 84% of our clients reunited with family members and children, and we expect that our success rate for 2020 to be well above 70%. So what makes Dove House stand out? Well, one of the big reasons is that we're free. We don't charge for our program. The number one barrier for people to access treatment is a cost. Many people that are in active addiction, they don't have the funds or the resources to access quality treatment. In the state of Indiana, there are only 4 treatment facilities that are free, and Dove House is one of them. Additionally, we don't require that a person have insurance to come into our program. The women that come into our program are the most vulnerable in our state. They've experienced homelessness or near homelessness. And so to expect a payment to come into our program would be nearly impossible. We don't require a weekly payment plan. We don't require that they have a job in 90 days. We don't require that their family members pay for them to come to Dove House because for many of them, they don't have family relationships anymore. What we do require of them is to take the time that they need to get healthy. We give them the gift of time, the time to focus on themselves and to access every single resource that we have to offer. At Dove House, we have intensive outpatient treatment groups, peer recovery, case management, one-on-one therapy, group therapy, relapse prevention classes, seeking safety, 12-step meetings, life skills, financial literacy classes, parenting classes, healthy relationships, and some faith-based programming. Every class is offered to help that woman become the best version of herself. Unfortunately, though, the harsh reality is that Dove House is one of very few programs available for women without insurance. On average, Dove House receives over 100 inquiries into our program. Currently, we have a 4 to 5 month wait list with about 45 women waiting for a bed. And this is unacceptable. The work that we're doing here at Dove House is urgent, it is critical, and it saves lives. When a woman makes a decision that she is ready to access treatment, she has about a 24-hour window to get into care. And that's because her brain has accepted the fact that she needs help. She has control over her urges. But much longer than that, that substance use disorder, that brain side of her that's unhealthy, grabs a hold of her and urges her to use again. We know that from firsthand experience that once she makes that decision, we need to get her into treatment immediately. Otherwise, we can lose them back to addiction. We can lose them back to homelessness, to the streets, even to death while waiting for a bed. In this heartbreaking reality, it's what keeps me up at night. It's what urges me to do more, to push more, to figure out what can we do to continue to serve the women, as many women as possible, the most vulnerable women in our community, as quickly as we possibly can. Evidence shows that homeless individuals who want to tackle their substance abuse issues need to be referred to treatment programs. Evidence supports that treatment is effective. We also know that 60% of women that are homeless suffer from mental and emotional disturbances, often coming way before they were homeless. Many homeless women became homeless in response to past with domestic violence and sexual trauma. Some of the women fled sex trafficking. Nearly 100% of the clients enter Dove House's residential recovery program have experienced homelessness or have unstable housing. And according to the National Institute of Health, as many as 80% of women seeking treatment for drug abuse report a lifetime history of sexual and/or physical assault. These women are living with complex layers of trauma. And this remains true for the clients of Dove House. So I'll go back to what I said before. Trauma is the missing part of our narrative around substance use disorder. Trauma came first. We've seen women of all walks of life come through the doors at Dove House. This is a disease that has no boundaries. It has no barriers. It doesn't care who you are. And I can guarantee you that every single person listening to this podcast knows someone that suffered from substance use disorder. We've seen women come through our doors that are teachers and lawyers, they're paralegals, prosecutors, even police officers. We've had women that have come through our doors that have been victims of sex trafficking, homelessness, and prostitution. But they're all women. They're women like us. They're sisters and they're mothers, they're daughters, they're friends. They have names like Jillian and Misty, Dana, Charity, Paula, Kelsey, Kelly, Jennifer, Carla, Antoinette, just to name a few. These women's lives have been changed because of Dove House, and they've changed my life. Let's take Paula, for instance. Paula came to Dove House from one of our referral partners, Hancock County Probation Department. Paula had had a lifetime of addiction, 20 plus years. And Paula was on 3 years of house arrest here at Dove House. Since she's been at Dove House, she is 2.5 years sober. She has graduated with a degree in culinary. She is now a chef and manages the Dove House kitchen and prepares all of our meals for the clients at Dove House. She's reunited with her family and most recently reunited with her daughter that she gave up for birth. She's now building a relationship with this daughter and is doing so because she's sober. These women that walk through our doors, they've changed the lives of all of us here at Dove House. The staff members, the community at large, me. These women are strong and they're resilient. My passion, my life's purpose has always been to provide a voice for women who have yet to find theirs. And when women come through the doors of Dove House, they do just that. They have the opportunity to find their voice. They find it and then they use it. These are women that we love. And as I said, these are women that are mothers and sisters, daughters. They're not their addiction. Substance use disorder is a disease. Evidence shows that substance use disorder is a chemical imbalance in a person's brain. And yet we define them as their disease. When a person is diagnosed with cancer, we don't say, oh, they're cancer. We don't define a person as someone with Alzheimer's. And yet, for some reason, when a person suffers from substance use disorder, we define them and we characterize them and we call them an addict, their disease. But again, at the core of their disease is trauma. At Dove House, our mission is simple. We empower women to become substance-free, self-sufficient, and healthy. And we do this by providing quality care, safe housing, and above all, hope for the future. We want the women to reunite with their family and friends and with their kiddos. And that's why every person that comes into our program, they work with a team of specialists to develop an individualized treatment plan. This treatment team includes a peer recovery case manager, a therapist, a group facilitator, and a director of clinical services. We help them identify their goals. What do they want to accomplish? Our motto here at Dove House is we don't expect them to meet us where we are. Rather, we meet them where they are. What do they want to accomplish in 30 days, in 60 days, in 90 days? What do they want to see in their future? Who do they want to be? How are they going to get there? And what's their best version? Our job is to help them reach their goals. Our goal is to ensure that every woman, regardless of her ability to pay, has an opportunity to live a long life, to remain substance-free, and healthy. I appreciate you taking the time to learn more about Dove House and to listen to this podcast. I ask that you help us change the narrative by inviting people that you know to subscribe to the Dove House podcast. For more information about Dove Recovery House, visit our website, doverecoveryhouse.org. You can also find us on all social media channels like Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and LinkedIn. Make sure to stay tuned for more episodes and subscribe. Thank you for listening. Have a great day and stay healthy.